أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ويقول الذين كفروا لولا أنزل عليه آية من ربه، قل إن الله يضل من يشاء ويهدي إليه من أناب. الذين آمنوا وتطمئن قلوبهم بذكر الله، ألا بذكر الله تطمئن القلوب. الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات طوبى لهم وحسن مآب. وعن أبي سعيد الخدري رضي الله تعالى عنه قال: قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: إن رجلا قال: يا رسول الله، طوبى لمن رآك وآمن بك. قال: طوبى لمن رآني وآمن بي، ثم طوبى ثم طوبى ثم طوبى لمن آمن بي ولم يرني. فقال الرجل: وما طوبى يا رسول الله؟ فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: شجرة في الجنة مسيرة 100 عام، ثياب أهل الجنة تخرج من أكمامها، أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. My respected brothers, elders and youngsters, this is just a reminder. Every after 7 days, Friday comes to us and we gather in the masjid, and this gathering, it is a very good gathering. This is a gathering of dhikr, remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, about what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is mentioning in hadith. This is the best majlis in the earth, the best creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, angels alayhim wa salam. They talk about those people who are sitting in this majlis and who are participating, and they are listening to the speech of Khatib, the speaker. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends His mercy to this majlis. Allah covers us with His mercy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends His mercy to us. In this ayat, the ayat what I recited, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning about the kuffar people, kuffar Quraysh, the disbelievers of the Quraysh, Makkah. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to call them towards the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those people, they deny, always they reject Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Always they drive him away from them. Always they used to curse Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never stopped his invitation, his calling towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And always they used to ask Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to bring a sign, a mu'jiza, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you are a true Nabi. Until we receive that sign, until we see that sign from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we can't believe you. We can't say that you are a true Nabi. We can't follow your religion. And they used to ask Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ask your Lord to change this mountain of Safa and Marwa to turn into the gold. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he requested Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he supplicated to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Jibreel alayhi sallam came to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he said, O Muhammad, tell me what you want. Because if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he turns into the gold, then Allah right away, he can do that. But after that, if your people, they don't believe you and in the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Allah will send such a punishment. Right away, Allah will destruct and destroy everything. What do you want? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives your nation a chance of tawbah. Then, upon their sins, they can, when they will feel and they will understand it, then they will seek repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Allah will forgive them. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, okay, I don't want to change this Safa mountain and Marwa mountain into gold. I don't want that. I want the Tawbah chance. Then Jibril alayhi wa sallam returned. And in this ayat, Allah is saying about those people, وَيَقُولُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لَوْلَا أُنزِلَ عَلَيْهِ آيَةٌ مِّن رَبِّهِ. Why, O Muhammad, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He doesn't send a sign with you, an angel, and we can believe you, and we cannot believe you until we see an angel. He is coming with you. But angels and human beings, they are not equal. Because angels, they are made by Noor. They are made by Noor. When they will come to you, they cannot eat your food. They will not. They cannot live with you. They cannot talk to you like regular people, like your friends and your family members. Only they have chance and they have permission to speak with the specific people who are receiving divine message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when they will see this angel, he is not talking to us, he is not meeting us, he is not participating in our majlis, then also they will stay away from him. They will not believe you. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, قُلْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُضِلُّ مَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيَهْدِي إِلَيْهِ مَنْ أَنَابُ. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala deviates the person whom He wills, and وَيَهْدِي إِلَيْهِ مَنْ أَنَابُ, and He guides the people, the one who repents to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, what is the meaning of إِلَيْهِ مَنْ أَنَابُ? أَنَابَ يُنِيبُ إِنَابَةً, الْإِنَابَةُ إِلَى اللَّهِ. To repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to return to your Lord. The meaning is those people who return to their Lord, those people who are believers. That's why its tafsir is done in next ayat. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, who are those people who return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? أَلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَتَطْمَئِنُّ قُلُوبُهُمْ بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. Those people, they return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who embraced Islam, who brought Iman in the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَتَطْمَئِنُّ قُلُوبُهُمْ بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. And they find their contentment in the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبُ. Indeed, know that when you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will find your tranquility and you will find your peace of mind. Then another, next ayat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, أَلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Now, what is the reward of the believers? Allah is saying, أَلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. Allah never mentioned آمَنُوا word without عَمَل. Wherever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, آمَنُوا, believers, Allah mentioned right away عَمَل word. Because after you bring Iman in the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after you believe the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, its meaning is not that you don't need to do any other thing. Just that's enough. No, you have to continue your Amal. You have to continue your actions. So Allah is saying, أَلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. Indeed, those people who are mu'minun and who did good deeds, طُوبَى لَهُمْ. They have glad tidings. طُوبَى لَهُمْ وَحُسْنُ مَآبٍ. And they had a good abode. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala kept for them good abode. Now what is the meaning of طُوبَى? طُوبَى لَهُمْ وَحُسْنُ مَآبٍ. So طُوبَى, its tafsir is done in Mufassir al-Kiram. They mention many words about the طُوبَى. Hazrat ibn Abbas radiyallahu ta'ala is saying, طُوبَى بِمَعْنَى الْجَنَّةِ. الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ طُوبَى لَهُمْ. The meaning is those people who are mu'minun and who have good deeds, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward them with Jannah. طُوبَى لَهُمْ. And Jannah, what is the good about? What is the better place than Jannah? What can be the better place than Jannah? Jannah. وَحُسْنُ مَآبٍ. In another narration it is said, طُوبَى, this is a tree of Jannah. The hadith, what I recited in this hadith, Abu Sa'id Khudri radiallahu ta'ala, who is narrating the hadith, A man, he came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he saw Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Ya Rasulullah, طوبى لمن رآك وآمن بك. Glad tidings for that person who saw you and who believed you. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam responded him with same word, طوبى لمن رآني وآمن بي. And he mentioned same word three times and he said, ثم طوبى, ثم طوبى, ثم طوبى لمن لم يرني وآمن بي. Glad tidings for that person, many, many glad tidings. Three times, kathrat. That's meaning is, we are here, we are sitting here. And we are mu'minun, we are believers. We believe in the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We believe that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he is the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He received a divine book, which is the best book, Al-Quran. We believe that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying, ثم طوبى, ثم طوبى, ثم طوبى, لمن, لمن لم يرني, the one who didn't see me and he believed me. لمن لم يرني وآمن بي. And he embraced Islam. He brought Iman upon me. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave glad tidings for that person. Then the person who said, طوبى لمن رآك, لمن رآك وآمن بك يا رسول الله. Rasulullah sallallahu, that person he asked, he questioned Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam again, Ya Rasulullah, what is the Tuba? And in that word, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explained the Tuba meaning. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying, شَجَرَةٌ فِي الْجَنَّةِ مَسِيرَةُ مِئَةِ عَامٍ. This is a tree which distance is 100 years. If you walk on that tree, under that tree, or if you ride something under that tree, then you cannot finish in 100 years. It is called Tuba. This is the Shajara of Jannah, a tree in Jannah. Subhanallah. Now imagine, if a person he receives Jannah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewards him with Jannah, then your Jannah, it is, how big is this? The person who will receive the smallest Jannah and last Jannah, in a hadith it is said, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying, which will be bigger, 10 times bigger than this one. The last person Jannah, it will be bigger, 10 times bigger than this world. Subhanallah. Now, these all rewards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he stored it for us, if we have good deeds. Now, just I want to remind you, if you know the recitation of the Quran, if you know the meaning of the Quran, if you understand the Quran, then recite it and ponder upon each ayat. In Surah Al-A'raf, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentioned many, many Anbiya Karam alayhim as-salam. First, he mentioned Nuh alayhi salam about his nation. Then he mentioned Hud alayhi salam and his nation. Then he mentioned Salih alayhi salam in his nation. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned Lut alayhi salam in his nations. Allah mentioned about Ibrahim alayhi salam and his nations. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned Shu'aib alayhi salam and his nations. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala finally mentioned elaborately Hazrat Musa alayhi salam and his nation. Those people, what they did with their Anbiya Karam alayhi salam. All Anbiya Karam alayhi salam, whenever they came to their nation, and previous Anbiya Karam alayhi salam, specifically Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used to send them to their nations. But Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent him to the whole universe. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying in the Quran, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنِّي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ إِلَيْكُمْ جَمِيعًا وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. Indeed, I am the messenger towards whole universe. إِنِّي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ إِلَيْكُمْ جَمِيعًا. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent him as a mercy of this world, this universe. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is not destroying us, sending his punishment at a time. Because all other Anbiya, when Nuh alayhi salam, he preached Islam in his nations, when they rejected him, Every day, Nuh alayhi salam, he used to visit door to door. And people, they used to hit him and they used to tell him he is Majnoon, he is crazy, he is mad. And they used to hit him. Finally, Hazrat Nuh alayhi salam, he was fainted and nobody would help him. Hazrat Nuh alayhi salam, when he gets his sense again, then Hazrat Nuh alayhi salam, next day again, he used to start his mission, and he used to call the people towards the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Again, they used to hit him. So finally, Hazrat Nuh alayhi salam made a dua against them, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala distracted them. Whole nation, only 80 people, only 82 people, 76 in some direction, different directions. So only those people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala kept them alive and left them alive, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then, this why Hazrat Nuh alayhi salam, he was called Abul Bashar Athani, the second father of the Ummah, father of the human being. Because Allah, the first father of the human being, he is Adam alayhi salam. And from him, we all are here. And second Abul Bashar, he is Nuh alayhi salam. Because from those 80 people, our progeny was spread in the world. That's why Hazrat Nuh alayhi salam, he used to be called Abul Bashar Athani, second father of the human being. So those people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, and their message was only one message. It is said, Hazrat Nuh alayhi salam is saying, لَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا نُوحًا إِلَىٰ قَوْمِهِ فَقَالَ. He went to his nation and he said, يَا قَوْمِ اعْبُدُ اللَّهِ. يَا قَوْمِ, O my nation, اعْبُدُ اللَّهِ, worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. مَا لَكُم مِّنْ إِلَٰهٍ غَيْرُ. There is no other one worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنِّي أَخَافُ عَلَيْكُمْ عَذَابَ يَوْمٍ عَظِيمٍ. I have fear of a great punishment on you. Then those people, they don't believe that. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Hud alayhi salam to Qawmi Aad. And Qawmi Aad, there are two groups of the Qawmi Aad. One is called Thamud and other one is called Aad. Hazrat Hud alayhi salam, his nation, they are called Aad al-Ula, first Qawmi Aad, and Hazrat Salih alayhi salam, his nation, they are called Aad al-Thani, they are Thamud. Hazrat Hud alayhi salam, he said same thing, وَإِلَىٰ عَادٍ أَخَاهُمْ هُودًا قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ اعْبُدُ اللَّهَ مَا لَكُمْ مِنْ إِلَٰهٍ غَيْرُهُ أَفَلَا تَتَّقُونَ. Same message. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Hazrat Salih alayhi salam to his nation, and he is saying, قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ اعْبُدُ اللَّهَ مَا لَكُمْ مِنْ إِلَٰهٍ غَيْرُهُ قَدْ جَاءَتْكُمْ بَيِّنَةٌ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ. Because Hazrat Salih alayhi salam, his nation, they requested him to bring a sign from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to bring a mu'jiza. And Hazrat Salih alayhi salam, he did two rakat namaz and he supplicated to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted his dua. Then Allah sent a camel to Salih alayhi salam, a pregnant camel, and right away it gave birth another camel like this size, same size. This is the mu'jiza of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Salih alayhi salam, tell your nation to not touch this camel and to not harm it, to not hit it. And one day they had a well, and one day your nation, they will take water, and another day they will leave this spring for this camel. It will come to this spring and it will drink water. But they didn't obey the command of Salih alayhi salam. They didn't obey the hukum of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Finally, after a few days, a man whose name is Qidar ibn Salif, he came and they incited that guy, and he came to this camel and he killed it. When they killed it, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warned Salih alayhi salam, tell your nation, they will wait 3 days, and after 3 days Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sending his punishment. Then first day, their face turned into red color. Second day, their face turned into yellow color. Then third day, their face turned into black color. They asked Hazrat Salih alayhi salam, what is the sign of that? Allah is sending a punishment to us. Then Salih alayhi salam told them, first day, after you wake up next morning, you will see your face in one direction. It is said, first time their face turned into yellow color, second time their face turned into red, then finally it turned into black color. Then next day, already they wear the cloth of kafan and they covered their body, and they are ready now to die. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent punishment to them. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Hazrat Lut alayhi salam, Shu'aib alayhi salam, لوط عليه السلام الله سبحانه وتعالى ولوطا إذ قال لقومه أتأتون الفاحشة ما سبقكم بها من أحد من العالمين إنكم لتأتون الرجال شهوة من النساء بل أنتم قوم مسرفون. الله mentioned about لوط عليه السلام and his nation. لوط عليه السلام, his nation, they did such a work. نعوذ بالله من ذلك. The Ummah of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم nowadays, those people, what they used to do, all nations of Anbiya Karam عليهم السلام, their bad habits we have in our nation. In the Ummah of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, despite that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not destroying us at a time. Why? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying in the Quran, مَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَأَنْتَ فِيهِمْ وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ مُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَهُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tell your people, as long as you are with them, with your nation, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never destroy your nation. And as long as after you die, then as long as they will be doing istighfar, they will be seeking forgiveness for their sins, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never destroy them at a time. So what a beautiful chance for us. What a beautiful chance for us. In a hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَبْسُطُ يَدَهُ بِاللَّيْلِ لِيَتُوبَ مُسِيءُ النَّهَارِ وَيَبْسُطُ يَدَهُ بِالنَّهَارِ لِيَتُوبَ مُسِيءُ اللَّيْلِ. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala extends His hands of mercy to the nation. And He spread it and He says, the one Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is calling the people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us chance. The one who committed sin during the daytime, now seek forgiveness. I am ready to forgive you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us chance also. The one who committed sin during the night time, seek forgiveness, I will forgive you. What a beautiful chance. And you see in the Quran, subhanallah, Quran Majid, this is beautiful literature. Very, very beautiful. In many, many ayat, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned about the previous nations, always Allah says, يَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ مِنْ ذُنُوبِكُمْ يَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ مِنْ ذُنُوبِكُمْ. Allah used the main word with the dhunub. But whenever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about the nation of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, without mean Allah says, يَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. هَلْ أَدُلُّكُمْ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا هَلْ أَدُلُّكُمْ عَلَى تِجَارَةٍ تُنْجِيكُمْ مِنْ عَذَابٍ أَلِيمٍ تؤمنون بالله ورسوله وتجاهدون في سبيل الله بأموالكم وأنفسكم ذلكم خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون. Then Allah is saying, يغفر لكم ذنوبكم. يغفر لكم ذنوبكم. Its meaning is the difference between mean and without mean is that then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whenever He mentions يغفر لكم من ذنوبكم, some of your sins Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive. And when Allah says without mean يغفر لكم ذنوبكم, its meaning is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive your all sins. This is only the chance of Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Allah is saying, هَلْ أَدُلُّكُمْ عَلَىٰ تِجَارَةٍ تُنْجِيكُمْ مِنْ عَذَابٍ أَلِيمٍ. Should I guide you towards the business? Then, عَلَىٰ تِجَارَةٍ which can save you from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah is saying, يَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. Allah will forgive your all sins. يَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ وَيُدْخِلْكُمْ جَنَّاتٍ تَجْرِي, and Allah will enter you in Jannah. Subhanallah. This is the khususiyat and speciality of Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then after Lut alayhi salam, Allah mentioned about the Shu'aib alayhi salam. وَإِلَى مَدْيَنَا أَخَاهُمْ شُعَيْبًا قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ اعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ مَا لَكُمْ مِنْ إِلَٰهٍ غَيْرُهُ قَدْ جَاءَتْكُمْ بَيِّنَةٌ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ فَأَوْفُوا الْكَيْلَ وَالْمِيزَانَ وَلَا تَبْخَسُوا النَّاسَ أَشْيَاءَهُمْ وَلَا تُفْسِدُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ بَعْدَ إِصْلَاحِهَا ذَلِكُمْ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ إِنْ كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. And finally Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned about Musa alayhi salam in Surah Al-A'raf. These Anbiya Ikram alayhi salam, in details their discussion and their description, it came in Surah Al-A'raf. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying about Musa alayhi salam, وَقَالُوا مَهْمَا تَأْتِنَا بِهِ مِنْ آيَةٍ لِتَسْحَرَنَا بِهَا فَمَا نَحْنُ لَكَ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given Musa alayhi salam 9 signs. First, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given him asa, his staff. His staff, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whenever he left it on the ground, then it turned into a scorpion. Then Fir'aun, out of fear, he started escaping from this one. And the scorpion, it is going to attack on the Fir'aun. And Fir'aun, he was in power more than 400 years. And in these 400 years, Fir'aun, he never felt a headache. He never suffered a fever. He never suffered runny nose. And on that day, on that day, Fir'aun, he used bathroom 400 times out of fear. on that day, and from that day and next day, from next day, he used to go, he had to go every day, more than 40 times, he had to use the bathroom after that day. And finally Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed him. So those people that didn't believe. And then consecutive five signs Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent to the Fir'aun and his nation, despite they didn't embrace Islam. They didn't believe in the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. First Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent a cyclone. Then it continued one Saturday till next Saturday. Then they came to Musa alayhi salam, and Musa alayhi salam requested to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah removed it. And one month Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them chance. And again they started doing same thing, and second time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent locust. Then whenever, in everything, whenever they sleep, whenever they stay at home, locust, they used to come to them and they used to fall in their foods and everything. They couldn't drink any water. Then again, it continued 1 week. Again Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala removed it and gave them chance 1 month. Again Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent another punishment, which is lice, which is in our head, lice. It used to cover their body, it used to cover their food. And whenever they take a morsel of the food in their mouth, into their mouth, then lice entered into their mouth. Then it continued again 1 week. Again Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala removed it and gave them chance 1 month. Again Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the dhafadi'a. وَأَرْسَلْنَا عَلَيْهِمُ الطُّوفَانَ وَالْجَرَادَ وَالْقُمَّلَ وَالضَّفَادِعَ وَالدَّمْ. And frogs, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whenever a person, he used to sleep at home, then the frogs, they would jump to him and it would cover his body. And he couldn't move to right side and left side, he couldn't move. Then finally Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala turned their waters into blood. Even though finally they came, and the very interesting thing is that Between the Qibti people, Fir'aun, his nation, they were called Qibti, and Musa alayhi salam, his nation, they were called Israel, Bani Israel. And one house is Bani Israel house is here, and next door is for Qibti person. Then next door Bani Israel, then next door is Qibti. But very interesting is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whenever he sent punishment to them, then the Qibti people, their house is full of punishment, but the Bani Israel people, their house is empty. But punishment. There's no punishment. That's why they used to go to the next door and they used to tell them finally that, okay, put water into your mouth, then throw it to, pass it to my mouth, from your mouth to my mouth. When they passed this water into their mouth, then it turned into blood. This kind of punishment Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them, despite they didn't bring is iman. But we need to ponder upon that. Time is done, time is over. So I am requesting everybody, so we seek forgiveness for our sins. Abu Dhul-Ghifar radiyallahu ta'ala is saying, ittaqillaha haythuma kunta. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says the hadith, ittaqillaha haythuma kunta. Wherever you are, have fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa atbi'i sayyi'ata al-hasanata tamhuha. And whenever you commit a sin, right away do a good deed, it will wipe away your sins. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala finally, وَأَتْبِعْ سَيِّئَةَ الْحَسَنَةَ تَمْحَهَا وَخَالِقِ النَّاسَ بِخُلُقٍ حَسَنٍ. And do good, behave good with the people. Behave good with the people. Whenever that's why this is a very beautiful greeting for us. Whenever we meet each other, then we say, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. See, an experience is this one. If you don't have experience, then try it. And start it from today. And everybody, when you have enmity, when you have a jealousy, then go to that person and say Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Then you will experience that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remove all the jealousy and enmity from your heart against that person. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to follow his deen. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillah rabbil alamin.